Interesting mix of stocks today. We've got IOL Chemicals, Yes Bank, Bharti Infratel that managed to see some gains. IndusInd, add that to the list. Escorts, Mahindra & Mahindra, some of the IT names, Tech Mahindra specifically. We had a Bandhan Bank also see some gains. United Spirits, PVR. Reliance had a really good day, 3.5% higher for an RIL. Axis Bank as well, a touch over 2%. Dr. Reddy's, Cholamandalam, M&M Financial, some of these other names as well. Very active, even though they closed with just minor gains. Overall, it was a relatively good day for some of these stocks. On the downside, though, we continue to see some pressure, some cooling off, actually, on the consumption names, I guess, which have been riding high. So HUL, Nestle, ITC, HUL, Britannia. Throw in a Titan on that, Asian Paints as well. The entire pack cooled off. OMCs continue to be sluggish. NIT Tech, after that move yesterday, also cooled off in trade today. No participation really from the likes of an ICICI Bank, Hero, L&T, from the heavyweights. Some of these names had just sat out. Bajaj Finance as well. Maruti down about 2% as well. So a couple of these names that didn't really participate, and an HCL Tech. So it was more stock specific rather than any major theme or trend that stood out, and clearly continuing to see somewhat of a range built in, within which we did see some of those stocks move. Avan, anything else that you're tracking?
Well, it's the future group of stocks that are active, future retail actually in particular. Do remember the reports indicate that Kishore Biyani is offering to sell that significant stake in his crown jewel to Amazon, and that will help to pair their massive debt level. So that's something that's in focus. You've got HUL as well, those multiple block deals. GSK, remember, selling over 5% at a discount of 3-8% to yesterday's closing price. And you've also got HCL Technologies. It's not been a bad set of quarterly numbers. They have managed to weather the storm, if you will, handing in a better than expected Q4 numbers. Though the management said that there will be weakness in Q1, but they're hopeful of a respite. Yes Bank as well, it sprung in a positive surprise actually. There was a one-time gain from the bond investment write-offs, and that offset some of the concerns when it comes to the widening losses. So those have been some of the newsmakers in today's trading session. But for the markets, all in all, well, we end at 9,200. So it's been a pretty trying day of trade, you'd have to say. The small cap index, though, that's been your silver lining. It's held out by about 0.7%. The Sensex 240 points lower, and the mid caps pretty much have followed suit. In terms of the sectors, consumption, finance, FMCG, as well as the Nifty Bank, sectors like pharma too have been down and out, while media, something like the PSU banks, as well as metals and real estate, they have managed to hold out in today's trading session. Just want to identify some of the other drags within the broader universe: Pidilite, BPCL, Godrej Consumer, Kotak, Airtel, Titan, as well as Zee Entertainment. They've been some of the drags in today's trading session. But we've also got plenty of numbers that will be coming out tomorrow. The street will be watching out for Shri Cement. There's Adani Gas, Reliance Capital, SBI Cards as well will be something to watch out for.